Hi everybody, today is February 2nd, 2013. Nukes could be hijacked by radicals, Pakistan scientists. I have done reports about the conflict between the militaries of Pakistan and India. These are both nuclear countries. The military in Pakistan is not controlled by the government, and they have come close to nuclear war 5 times so far. Currently, there has been a rise in conflicts there on the border between Pakistan and India. India told its citizens last week, I believe it was, to prepare for nuclear war and to start building bomb shelters. Increasing radicalization within Pakistan's military could lead to its nuclear weapon being hijacked by radical Islamics, a Pakistan scientist has warned. Safety and security of Pakistan's nuclear arsenal is of a major concern. The growing radicalization within the military, given attacks on its own internal bases, could lead to these nuclear weapons being hijacked by radical Islamics, said Professor Hoodboy, who was here for the London launch of his book, Confronting the Bomb. The nuclear physicist and defense analyst estimated Pakistan's arsenal to be similar to India, at around 120 to 130 warheads. He was answering questions from members of the Indian Journalists Association at the Andali launch here last week. Earlier, such weapons were seen just as means of deterrent. The most dangerous development in the increasing search for fissile material has a new dimension of tactical nuclear war has entered the picture. This means the number of weapons will steadily increase, he said. Hoodboy, who received his PhD in nuclear physics from Massachusetts Institute of Technology, MIT, stressed that the issue needs to be addressed for the sake of subcontinental as well as global security. India and Pakistan have come close to nuclear war at least 5 times. In 1987, 1990, during Kargil, 1999, after the attack on the Indian Parliament, 2001, and the Mumbai attacks in 2008. Given the history of nuclear tensions, we can't afford to be passive on this issue. The fallout from the blast itself to the radioactive effects will be felt not just in the subcontinent but around the world, he said. Confronting the Bomb, Pakistani and Indian Scientists Speak Out, published by Oxford University Press and edited by Hoodboy, is a compilation of essays by scientists from both sides of the border. It kicks off with an atomic age in India in 1974, followed by Pakistan, and traces the furious nuclear race after the 1998 nuclear tests. Pakistan started developing its nuclear weapons only because India embarked on it. India has remained primarily energy, but to some extent that perception is changing, with General Kayani, chief of Pakistani Army Staff, recently saying that Pakistan's major challenge is the enemy within. So there seems to be a doctrinal shift within the army, but Kayani himself is under attack within the forces, said Hoodboy, who admits to receiving threats against his own life. Jihadists still operate within Pakistan, and the state's policy regarding Islamics has been a confused one, at Hoodboy, a visiting professor in the physics department at Lahore University of Management Sciences. He is known for speaking out against Pakistan's nuclear establishment. He is even now skeptical of the peaceful uses of nuclear technology in India and Pakistan. Whether electricity generated from nuclear sources is really efficient is a big question mark. The construction of nuclear reactors is very expensive, and should an accident similar to Japan's Fukushima disaster in 2011 were to occur in India or Pakistan, both countries may not have the capability to deal with it in the same way, he added. Deal with it in the same way? The way Japan dealt with Fukushima was a total screw-up, and it's still ongoing. At least 3 reactors melted down into the groundwater, into the ocean, into the air. And it could be worse than that if Pakistan or India had a disaster similar. That's kind of scary. All right, bookmark my site. I'll keep everyone up to date. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.